Lyte, what you stopping for?
Y'all want to take the subway.
The subway?
I just got this feeling. I want to take the subway.
You got this bad jet sitting here. You want to take the subway?
Yo, D, what's up with
him? Cat, go with him.
What's she want to take the subway for?
I don't know. I'm going to take a car home.
This program contains subject matter and language that may be disturbing to some viewers. Viewer discretion is advised.
And if you don't like DF, I'm saying, kick rocks with no socks while wearing flip-flops. Let's go.
What's up, everybody? Welcome to the channel. My name is Kiva, and I'm excited to be joining SFC Spectacular on this artist. Truly an unsung artist. I learned a lot of things I didn't know about this artist, and I grew up in this era with this artist, so this was very fun to do. So I hope you will enjoy it as much as I did. So let's get to it. According to Merriam's Dictionary, rap music is defined as a type of music that is of an African-American origin, often rhythmic, and usually contains rhyming speech chanted to a musical accompaniment. In all the years of rap's existence, few have achieved the status of legend. Countless performers have come and go since the genre's early days, but a select few not only have made their names known, but to this day continue to impress with their lyrical abilities. Hello everyone, I'm Kiva.
And I'm SFC Spectacular.
And today we wanted to do a video that's a bit different. A video that perhaps will enlighten and enrich your mind about one of the unsung musical greats of the rap community. So sit back, grab some snacks, and hopefully enjoy. In 1960s, the word rap began to pop up in the black community as a slang word to mean that someone was talking or having a conversation. Can I rap with you for a minute, one might ask? It is said that in August of 1973, somewhere in the Bronx, musical history was made.
DJ Kool Herc, known as the first DJ and founding father of hip hop,
and his sister Cindy began hosting back-to-school parties in their building. In these gatherings, that would spark the beginning of a new culture. During one of these parties, Coke LaRock recited his very first bar.
There's not a man that can't be thrown, a horse that can't be rolled, a bull that can't be stopped. There's not a disco that I, Coke LaRock, can't rock. And I put the echo in the echo chamber. That's why you got Coke LaRock, rock, rock. Cool DJ Herc and Coke LaRock. Serious.
Okay, so at the very first party, you guys were rocking the echo and making rhymes.
Yeah.
This one bar arguably made Coke LaRock the very first rapper that birthed a new genre of music we know today as rap music.
Notable artists at the time include DJ Kool Herc, Grandmaster Flash and the Furious Five, Fab Five Freddy, Marley Marl, African Bambaataa, Kool Moe Dee, Curtis Blow, Dougie Fresh, Houdini, and many more. But what about the first female rap artist? In 1969, Lolita Shantae Gooden was born in Queens, New York, where she lived with her mother and sisters. She started rapping at the age of 9 and changed her name from Lolita to Roxanne at 14. Although she is listed as the first female rap artist by release date and year of recorded work, she merely opened the door for this video's topical artist.
If we travel back to October 11th, 1970, we find that a young woman named Lena Michelle Moore was born. Mrs. Moore is better known professionally as MClyte. Many consider this woman to be the true first lady of rap. She gained fame and prominence in the late 80s, becoming the first solo female rapper to release a full album with 1988's critically acclaimed Lyte as a Rock. Her artistic career, she published a total of 8 studio albums, obtained a Soul Train Award, and 2 Grammy nominations, among other accolades. Today, we take a look at her career as the legendary MClyte.
Lana Michelle Moore was born and raised in Brooklyn, New York. It's been said she began rapping at the age of 12. Lana's original stage name was Sparkle, and she began recording her first track at the age of 14. It took nearly 2 years before it was released. At age 17, she released her first song, I Cram to Understand You.
She said, hello, my name is Sam. I said, hi, my name is Mike. We yip and we yap and we chit and we chat about this and that from sneakers to hats. She said, look, I'm in the mood for love simply because you're near me.
This song was about the crack epidemic and its impact on relationships. Even at early stages in her career, she showed great concern for her community. In the late 80s, MClyte began publicly outshining other MCs, male and female. In September 1988, she released her first album, Lyte as a Rock, which she had been working on for several years. The album was notable for its hits, Paper Thin. In May of the very same year, she was featured in the remix video of I Want Your Hands on Me by Irish singer Sinead O'Connor on MTV, making her one of the few rap artists to cross over and perform with other major musical genre giants.
Lyte followed her debut album with the 1989's album Eyes on This, which spawned the hits Cha Cha Cha, an absolute hit that paved the way for her next track, Cappuccino. Lyte's first two albums were notable for their uncensored subjects. She was unafraid to tackle topics such as drugs,
young love, sex, and the general state of her community.
In 1991, Act Like You Know was noted for its new jack swing sound and the hit single MClyte tried her hand at acting in 1991 in an off-Broadway theater play titled Club 12, a hip-hop twist on 12th Night alongside Wyclef Jean, Lauryn Hill, and Lisa Nicole Carson. Lyte's fourth album, 1993's Ain't No Other, was her first to reach gold status and spawned the hit Roughneck. This song was nominated for a Grammy Award for Best Rap Single, making MClyte the first female solo rapper to be nominated for the coveted award. Spurred on by her success with prior acting projects, she decided to try films. MClyte made her first film debut in 1993, movie titled Fly By Night, starring alongside Jeffrey Sams, Ron Bryce, and Steve Gomer. 2 years afterward, Lyte's fifth album, Bad As I Wanna Be, produced the hits Keep On, Keepin' On, and Cold Rock a Party, the latter of which also featured then and upcoming rapper, songwriter, and producer, Missy Elliott. The album was her first with East West Records America and became successful after the aforementioned singles were big hits. Bad As I Wanna Be became her second gold album. In 1997, Lyte tried her hand at business when she launched Sunny Girl, Inc. The company was a global entertainment firm that specialized in artist management, development, production, creative services, and consulting. Lyte returned to the studio in 1998 with follow-up album 7 and 7. However, this album was not as successful as her past efforts. She left her record label East West America by the end of the decade. Lyte later released the independently produced record The Underground Heat featuring Jamie Foxx in 2003, which was notable for the song Ride With Me. Like Nestle, thick like Wesley, snipe out. I'm the type to be about crashing up in your joint and knocking the lights out. Feeling lovely, trust me, I'm drug free. Only true dogs bringing out the thug in me. The single was nominated for both a Grammy and a BET award. Lyte took a hiatus from music and did more films such as A Love Tale in 1999, Train Ride in 2000, Civil Band in 2002, and Players Ball in 2003.
In 2013, MClyte received the Lifetime Achievement Award at the inaugural Hip Hop Ball. She was the first female rap solo artist to receive BET's I Am Hip Hop Icon Life Achievement Award. After 12 years without an album, MClyte dropped her 8th album, Legend, on April 18th, 2015. Ball, featuring Little Mama and AV, and Check are singles spawned from that album. I'm gonna give you the code, let that future unfold. I had to follow them rules, that's how I opened them doors. I put that work in, check. I hustle hard, check. I pay my dues, yep. I gave you hits like Buff Neck, and I'm still grinding, yep. Still shining, yep. I'm all that's left, yep. I'm still the best, but you ain't yet. In early 2016, she started dating Marine Corps veteran and entrepreneur John Weich. They announced their engagement in May 2017, and in August, at 46 years old, they exchanged their vows during a musical wedding in Montego Bay, Jamaica. In 2017, Lyte continued her acting, where she played Detective Makenia Daniels in the drama series Tales.
MClyte blazed a trail in the genre of rap for not only female rappers, but all rappers. As she and her colleagues ventured the uncharted waters of rap music, it was clear she did it with a purpose. For those who aren't familiar with her work, we suggest you listen to some of her music as soon as you can. In doing research for this video, we found much of MClyte's music was on Spotify and YouTube. If you enjoyed this video, let us know down in the comments and perhaps we can produce more. We thank you as always for watching, and please be safe and enjoy your day.
What's good, Spectacular Soldiers? If you're like me, then you're upset that video's over. Fear not. Check out the videos listed below. Still bored, I hear you say? Then check out my other YouTube channel. We require more content, I hear you exclaim. Well, then you can find me on Instagram, find me on Twitter, and Mixer, where I stream weekdays starting at 6 p.m. Eastern Standard Time. And luckily for you, the name is the same everywhere. Until next time, if you can't be good at it. Take care of yourselves. Peace.